Have you ever seen one of those really nice big camera arms they have in professional photo studios? The ones that have a camera attached to a long arm that can swing up and down and reach all the way over a table? Well, I haven't seen one in real life either, but I've seen them online and I really want one. The only problem is, turns out they're really expensive. Some of them cost up to $10,000. So I decided to make one. I'm gonna make that out of some aluminum square tubing, a bunch of bearings, some nuts and bolts, some wheels, a big chunk of steel, and a whole bunch of printed parts. Let's start building. So this entire camera arm thing can be divided into two main parts. The part that goes up and down and the part that can slide from side to side. We're gonna start building the part that goes up and down. Now, I want this camera rig to be able to go from all the way down on the ground here and all the way up to the ceiling so that I can do overhead shots like this. And to achieve that, I'm gonna use this aluminum square tubing. And to make sure everything is stiff enough, we're gonna connect these two aluminum tubes together. We're gonna do that by flipping them on the side and then connect them together like that. And to make sure that the spacing is correct between these, I 3D printed a bunch of these spacer pieces that will sit in between the two tubes like this. And to hold everything together, I'm gonna drill some holes through both pipes and then insert one of these into the end here. And then the bolt will go through the tubes, through the plastic piece, and into this guy here. So this thing is basically just a fancy washer. All right, so I've marked up all the locations for where I want to drill the holes in these tubes. Now, since I want these tubes to face each other diagonally, I'm gonna have to drill the holes diagonally through the tubes. And to help me achieve that, I've 3D printed these guide blocks here, which are essentially just a V block. In this one, I printed the hole big enough to fit a couple of bearings, which just so happened to fit the size drill bit that I'm gonna be using. I've made one guide block that will fit the drill bit that's the same size as the threaded part, and I've made another guide block that will fit a bigger drill bit for the head of the screw to fit through. For this one, I didn't have a bearing that fit, so I just turned on a piece of steel and then glued that in there. So that was all the holes drilled in this guy. I've now got it so that the head of the bolt I'll be using fits through one of the sides and the threaded part fits through the other side. This whole assembly is gonna go together with these spacer pieces that are gonna have these square nuts going into the holes. I was hoping it was gonna slide down. Yay! And then the bolt goes through there, and the plastic piece is now behind here. Huh? I think this is gonna work. Right, so this is gonna be standing upright, so let's start making something that it can stand on. We'll put this aside for just a second, and I'll grab this 30 mil thick sheet of MDF, out of which I'm gonna make the base that this whole thing is gonna be rolling around on. Now, since I had to model all this in 3D anyways, since I had to model the parts that I 3D printed, I was also able to make some templates for this base. So I'm just gonna cut these out, glue them together, stick them on here. That way I know all the hole locations and I don't need to do any measuring. Just like I did in the chair or the side table I built. Alright, so the base is cut out, I've drilled a whole bunch of holes, and I've attached a couple of wheels. All these holes will start making sense in just a second when we start assembling stuff, so that's what we're gonna do right now. We're gonna continue with our big aluminum piece here, and I've 3D printed a couple of these big Y joints here. that are gonna slip right onto the bottom of these tubes. And now I've also printed a couple of more of these triangle pieces. These are a little different. These will actually have nuts that go into the hex holes in the back. And then just like the other ones, they'll go into the tube and align with the holes in the Y joints here. And then last but not least, this guy, which is just one of the middle spacer pieces with a little bit more of a base attached to it. That will allow me to attach this whole thing to the base that we just made. So this thing is starting to come together. The next step is to attach these pieces. This is the same aluminum tubing that I've cut to length and I've cut a 45 degree angle on both sides. I've also drilled a hole in one of the ends for the screw that will go through the Y piece here. So now these pieces will go in there. And then I've got some 3D printed feet that will go onto the ends of here. And now we can finally start to see how all these pieces are gonna come together. Wow. This thing is gonna be huge. So now all these holes that we just drilled in the base will make a lot more sense because they're all holes for these feet, which with any sort of luck should align to these 3D printed parts. I just wanna make sure that everything lines up and that these leg pieces here have the right length. So I'm just gonna insert a bunch of screws in all the holes. And then when I'm confident that everything will fit, I'll mark the last location for the screw that will go in the bottom here. Take everything apart, drill the last hole, and then we can assemble it. Now you can see why I drilled these big holes in the bottom here. That is so that I can have nuts and washers that attach these screws and have the bottom side here completely flush because we're going to utilize the space later in the build. Wow, I'm not going to lie. Seeing it in real life and how big it's actually going to be is a little bit different than seeing it in like this size on a screen. All right, so now to the fun bit, which is going to be connecting this whole thing to this thing here, which is just made up of the same aluminum square tubing with the spacers in between. So this is what's going to become the arm that will be able to go up and down as well as in and out. And to connect these two pieces, you guessed it, I've got a whole bunch more of 3D printed parts. So these four 3D printed parts here are easily one of the more complex pieces of this entire build, as well as probably one of the more complex pieces that I've ever printed in any of my projects on this channel. So these four pieces are what is going to connect the two main assemblies here and allow everything to slide and move freely and smoothly. Oh, and by the way, each one of these is about 700 grams of filament, so they're pretty sturdy. And they each took 30 hours to print. This is the Galaxy Black filament by Prusa, which they kindly sent me for this build. So thank you very much, guys. It looks great. All right, so 32 bearings later, we've got all of these set up and ready to go. And these can now go on the end of these aluminum tubing. And they will slide back and forth on the bearings. And to get this whole thing nice and tight, we're gonna attach two of these to get it like this. So these pieces are gonna go on each their own aluminum tube here, and they're ultimately gonna slide back and forth like this. Now, instead of just bolting these together, I've actually left a little bit of a gap in between here so that I, with the help of a couple of bolts, can adjust the exact distance these two are gonna have relative to each other. And doing it this way will allow me to take up any sort of slack that could be caused by print inaccuracies or inaccuracies in the tubes or just the way I measured stuff. So, bolt goes in there, through to the other side, nut goes in on this side, and then when I feel I've tightened everything the exact right amount, I've inserted a couple of square nuts on each side next to this bolt with a smaller bolt that I can use to tighten onto the big one so that the adjustment doesn't come out of alignment. And after tightening all the bolts and somewhat adjusting everything, I feel like this is pretty promising. So obviously we need some way of actually locking this in place. And for that, I made these guys. These are just 3D printed knobs that have a space for a M8 hex bolt and a lid at the end. And these things are gonna go into these holes on this side here, and they thread into a nut on the other side of the plastic here. Pushes on one of these little 3D printed parts with a little felt bit on here. These are the same as you would put underneath furniture. So when I tighten this, that felt piece gets pushed into the aluminum and locks this thing in place. And I've got two of those, one for each side. So this whole package is actually meant for the part that is gonna go up and down. So let's put it on there. This seems to work pretty well. And the locking knob also works just fine. It's pretty securely attached. Now, this is just one of the axes. The next one basically looks the same. It's just another one of these assemblies with a bunch of bearings in them. It looks a little bit different because this one will attach to this one, and there's a little bit of adjustability between all these parts to make sure that I can take up the slack and actually adjust it to run perfectly smooth in both directions. Look at this thing! Just look at this! I think this might actually work. Right, so there's one obvious flaw with the way this is set up right now. And that is that as soon as I undo the two knobs on the back here, this whole thing is gonna come crashing down unless I hold it up myself. And that problem is only gonna get a lot worse once I put the heavy camera and all the other stuff on here. So we have to address that, which means more 3D printed parts. Oh, okay. So we're all the way up at the ceiling of my workshop because I can't be bothered flipping this whole thing over again. I'm gonna be installing this thing, which is just one of the spacer pieces with an extra bit attached to it that will hold this wheel. This wheel has a couple of bearings inside of it and a groove that will hold a rope. And this thing is gonna go on the top here. Oh, hold on. I almost forgot this bit, which will make more sense in a second. Ah, we'll just leave that there for now. And then this bit goes up top here, and everything fits nice and snug. Okay, next up, more printed parts. So if you haven't guessed it by now, I'm doing a counterweight system that'll make sure that the whole thing doesn't come crashing down on its own. But for that to work properly, I need to know exactly how much this whole assembly is gonna weigh, and that's why we're gonna install the rest of the pieces on this now. And by the rest of the pieces, I mean the part that is gonna go in the front and the back of this thing. On the front here, obviously, that's where the camera is gonna go. And for that, I printed this part. Again, just one of those spacer pieces with some extra bits. This one goes on there, triangles, and we'll just attach that there. And on the other side, almost the same thing, except a normal spacer piece, and those triangles are replaced by this whole thing, which will act like an end cap. And because we want stuff to look nice, I printed these little end caps. Okay, so it's time to start putting on some gear so we can figure out how much this whole thing is gonna weigh. We've got one of these magic arms, which is like an articulated arm that locks in place with that lever. This thing will go into the hole here, and then using the bolt in the back, I can lock the bottom of the arm in place so that this arm now can articulate all the way around here. I can lock it in place and it stays here. And on that arm, we're gonna attach one of these monitors. There-ish for now. And then we've got this ball head thingy, which will go on right there. This thing out of the way here. And you guys are coming with me. First time on the actual new camera stand. Exciting. Cool. Okay, so this is where it gets kind of interesting. Now we're gonna try and figure out how much this entire assembly weighs so that we can make a counterweight for it. And since I need to weigh the camera, it needs to stay attached to the camera arm while I'm doing this. So you're stuck there. Hold on, I can move a little bit further away. Got a piece of string. I'm gonna tie that string to the assembly here, and then it will go through the hole in this thing and up and around here. Now, if this works, I should be able to loosen all of this. Oh, it's pretty heavy. And this thing goes up and down. Time to figure out how much all this weighs. And you know what? That is actually pretty easy. I've just got one of these luggage weights. I'll hook it on here. Make sure everything is completely loose. And that will be 13 kilos exactly. All right, so we're gonna need something that can work as a counterweight that is exactly 13 kilos. Now, do you remember the intro where I had a big chunk of steel? This thing just so happens to be, how much was it? 12.8 kilos. That is really close. I mean, I knew that it was gonna be kind of close, but this close, I got pretty lucky. So this is just a chunk of 90 millimeter steel bolt, which I've drilled a hole in the center of and tapped to M8 threads. That way I can take this piece of threaded rod that I cut to a nice length and thread that into the top here. Now I want to be able to have a little bit of adjustability in terms of weight for the counterweight, since I might want to upgrade my equipment in the future to maybe a heavier camera or to maybe bigger batteries. So I want to be able to add more weight fairly easily. I'm going to do that with this thing. This is literally just a 3D printed cup with three compartments and a hole all the way through. And this thing is just gonna go onto the threaded rod like that. What that will allow me to do is to fill these compartments here with some heavy stuff in case I need to increase the weight of the counterweight. And I've got a bunch of these weighted bags that I got from Exercise Weight West. And these are half a kilo each. And these things can just go into the compartments here. And I can increase the weight of this by an additional 3 kilos. And so that all this is securely held in place. I've got this little eye hook that will just thread onto there and lock everything nicely in place. Let's try it out. So this thing is currently empty and I just wanna try out if this is gonna work at all. Let's see if this works. It's a little bit heavy. Oh, hold on. I forgot this camera. Okay, so let's try that again. Ah! Are you kidding me? It works. That's so cool. All right, so this seems to work really, really well. The very last thing that we need to deal with is that right now, this weight is just dingling around, which means that if I move it around a bit, this thing is just gonna start crashing into everything, which we don't want. So what I wanna do to keep this thing from dangling around is to use this pipe here and have the weight run inside of the pipe. And in addition to that, just in case I ever do something stupid, like take off too much weight so the whole thing will come crashing down, I wanna make sure that nothing gets damaged. So for the bottom of this pipe, I've 3D printed my own little pipe section that comes with a lid that really nicely fits in here. And inside of this short little section of 3D printed pipe, I'm gonna have a couple of pieces of this fairly stiff and strong spring so that if that heavy weight ever would come crashing down really fast, there would be something that would cushion the blow. So we'll just cut this into a couple of pieces and then install everything. Seems to work pretty well. And that's it. Look at this thing. Isn't this just incredibly cool? I cannot believe how well this works. Everything is assembled. Everything works really well. I've also painted the base here black. The whole thing can go all the way from down here to all the way up here. And you can see once it hits the top, the weight at the bottom hits the springs, so it has a nice cushioned stop. And I think one of the coolest things about this whole thing is the fact that it can go from all the way back here to all the way out there without tipping over. And the way I achieve that is that on the bottom here, on the opposite end of where this thing extends to, there's a big concrete weight. I 3D printed a couple of holders that screw into the holes that I drilled in the bottom of the plate, and they hold a concrete weight that I cast into a mold that I made out of a couple of scrap pieces of MDF, just like I did for the counterweights for the assortment cabinet as well. And I think one of the things that I'm really, really pleased with is the fact that I can push this whole thing up and down using just one finger, as well as pushing this thing in and out using just one finger. It works so well. All right, so I'm sure a lot of you are wondering how much printing time and how much filament all this took. We'll get into that in just a second, but first, I really want to compare the performance of this thing compared to the tripod that I've been using so far, which is on the camera right now. This is the tripod I've been using for all my videos so far. It's really nice and sturdy, but over the years I've been using this, I've just gotten really tired of having to adjust the legs all the time. And no, I don't have more than one extra camera, so you'll have to pretend that there's a camera on top of here. So when using this thing and I wanted to get shots that are really low to the ground, I had to do the following. Undo all the legs, push them down here, and then if I want to get it even lower, I needed to do, which is okay, it gets annoying. Now I can just do that. Granted, it doesn't go as low, but I'll live. The really cool thing though is in the other direction. So going from all the way at the bottom, you have to kind of undo all of these legs. And now the footprint of this thing is much bigger, so I can't really get any close to anything. And this is the max height. Doing that with this thing, pretty easy, huh? I love this thing. So as I mentioned, the problem with this thing is that the footprint gets really big, so you can't get close to anything. And you can definitely not get over anything, which is one of the biggest problems I've had so far. You see, right about here is normally where I have the camera in shots like, for instance, the intro shot like this. But the issue is, if I want to get any closer than this, I can't do it with this tripod. So then I end up having to switch from this tripod to this little gorilla pod, meaning that I have to take the camera off this and onto there, and then I have to somehow try and prop this thing up and then point it at me at like an appropriate distance. And this thing ends up very often kind of like sagging over time. So yeah, let's compare that to my new camera arm. So I guess just about where you are now is where I normally would have the camera on the tripod. And if I want to move any closer now, then let you just do that. You see, all of a sudden you're really close. And I can go up, just like that. Or even get really close to the work surface if I want to explain something that's small and detailed. You see, with this thing, I can never get any higher than about where you are now. So this angle was literally impossible for me before this. Now, there's one more thing that is really cool about this, and that is the fact that I now can do overhead shots without having to move the camera away from the stand. In case you haven't figured it out yet, I'm really happy about this. All right, so let's quickly talk about how much material I used and how long all this took to print. So all in all, there's 27 individual 3D printed parts that I all had to model from scratch, making up a total of 64 printed parts because I had to print multiple of some of the parts. And all of this ended up taking 9.2 kilograms of plastic, and it took 346 hours to print all of that. I used two printers to print this, and between all the testing and the modifications and reprinting and some failed parts, this project has taken me months to finish. Like, I have a box full of parts that I didn't end up using. Now, if you like this project, and if you for some reason want to build one of these for yourself, I will have the SDL files as well as all the documentation I used to build this thing available to download on my website, which will be linked in the description below. Initially, I wasn't sure whether or not I should make all this available for download because I don't want to be responsible for someone putting in this much time and effort into printing all these parts and then it not fitting together correctly. I mean, there can always be slight differences between printers and the clearances and tolerances. So if you do decide to try and build one of these for yourself, keep that in mind. But to at least try to make it as easy as possible for you, if you want to build one of these, I'll include all the SDL files, as well as all the templates I used for the base, as well as the drawings for aluminum profiles with all the hole placements and the lengths they need to be. and I'll make a list of all the nuts and bolts and washers and bearings that you'll need to complete the project. But as I said, all that is on your own risk. The link will be in the description below to the site where you can download all this. On the same site, you can also find a bunch of templates and build guides for a bunch of my other projects, as well as my merchandise store if you're interested in getting yourself a cool t-shirt or a hoodie and supporting my channel at the same time. And as for now, I really hope you enjoyed watching this video. If you did, make sure to give it a thumbs up. It actually makes a huge difference if you do. Make sure to subscribe if you're not yet and ring that bell so you get notified every time I upload something new. As for now, thanks so much for watching, and I'll see you guys in the next video. Bye-bye.